This illustration is for analysis of motion of a block relative to a rod. Here the figure shows a pulley system in which block 1 is 1.8 times that of the rod 2, its mass is 1.8 times that of rod 2, and length of rod is L, and all strings and pulleys are ideal. And it is saying when the system is released, block 1 was in the seam level of lower end of the rod. We are required to find the time after which the block will be opposite to the upper end of the rod. So, in this situation here, we can draw the situation again with the free body diagram. Here you can see if this is block 1 and this is the rod 2. Here the string is fixed. Obviously, here you can see if on this string tension is T, here it will be 2T. And the mass of 1 is less than twice the mass of 2. That means if 2 is going down, 1 will be going up. If 1 is going up with an acceleration A, then by constraint relation here we can see 2 will come down with acceleration 2A. And if we consider mass of this rod as M, then the mass of this block 1 can be taken as 1.8 M. Now in this situation, if we write equation of motion for 1 and 2, then here we can see for this rod we can write as it is going down, we can write mg minus t is equals to m multiplied by 2a, which is say equation 1. And for block we can write this 2t minus 1.8 mg is equals to 1.8 ma, this is our equation 2. To simplify, we multiply this equation by 2 and we add the two equations, so this tension gets cancelled out. And this will give us 2 mg minus 1.8 mg is 0.2 mg, which is equals to this 4 ma plus 1.5 ma is 5.8 ma. So here m gets cancelled out and the value of acceleration we are getting is 2 by 58, that is g by 29. So, this is going up with acceleration A and 2 is coming down with acceleration 2A. So, if we calculate acceleration of 1 with respect to 2, if we consider this rod to be at rest, this going up and this acceleration of 1 with respect to 2, we can write 3A. That will be 3G by 29. So, if the rod is of length L, we are required to find the time after which block will be opposite to the upper end of the rod. So, here we can write if block 1 is opposite to upper end of rod after time t, this implies we can use L is equals to half a of 1 with respect to 2 multiplied by t square. So, this will give us the time as root 2L by acceleration of 1 with respect to 2. If we substitute the value, a of 1 with respect to 2 is 3g by 29. So, on substituting, we are getting it as 58l by 3g. That will be the final result of this problem.